Preface. The following are some of Aesop's best-loved fables. The Goose with the Golden Eggs. A certain man had the good fortune to possess a goose that laid him a golden egg every day, but dissatisfied with so slow an income, and thinking to seize the whole treasure at once, he killed the goose, and cutting her open, found her just what any other goose would be. Much wants more, and loses all. The Town Mouse and the Country Mouse. A country mouse invited a town mouse, an intimate friend, to pay him a visit and partake of his country fare. As they were on the bare ploughed lands, eating their wheat stalks and roots pulled up from the hedgerow, the town mouse said to his friend, "You live here the life of the ants, while in my house is the horn of plenty. I am surrounded with every luxury, and if you will come with me, as I much wish you would, you shall have an ample share of my dainties." The country mouse was easily persuaded, and returned to town with his friend. On his arrival, the town mouse placed before him bread, barley, beans, dried figs, honey, raisins, and last of all, brought a dainty piece of cheese from the basket. The country mouse, being much delighted at the sight of such good cheer, expressed his satisfaction in warm terms, and lamented his own hard fate. Just as they were beginning to eat, someone opened the door, and they both ran off squeaking as fast as they could, to a hole so narrow that two could only find room in it by squeezing. They had scarcely again begun their repast, when someone entered to take something out of a cupboard, on which the two mice, more frightened than before, ran away and hid themselves. At last the country mouse, almost famished, thus addressed his friend, "Although you have prepared for me so dainty a feast, I must leave you to enjoy it by yourself. It is surrounded by too many dangers to please me. Better a little in safety than an abundance surrounded by danger." The Milkmaid and Her Pot of Milk. A maid was carrying her pail of milk to the farmhouse when she fell a musing. "The money for which this milk will be sold will buy at least 300 eggs. The eggs, allowing for all mishaps, will produce 250 chickens. The chickens will become ready for market when poultry will fetch the highest price, so that by the end of the year I shall have money enough to buy a new gown. In this dress I will go to the Christmas junketings, when all the young fellows will propose to me, but I will toss my head and refuse them every one." At this moment she tossed her head in unison with her thoughts, when down fell the milk pot to the ground, and broke into 100 pieces, and all her fine schemes perished in a moment. Count not your chickens before they are hatched. The Man and the Satyr. A man and a satyr once formed a bond of alliance. One very cold wintry day, as they talked together, the man put his fingers in his mouth and blew on them. On the satyr inquiring the reason, he told him that he did it to warm his hands. Later on in the day they sat down to eat, the food prepared being quite scalding. The man raised one of his dishes towards his mouth and blew in it. On the satyr again inquiring the reason, he said that he did it to cool the meat. "I can no longer consider you as a friend," said the satyr. "A fellow who with the same breath blows hot and cold, I could never trust. A man who talks for both sides is not to be trusted by either." The Mice in Council. The mice summoned a council to decide how they might best devise means for obtaining notice of the approach of their great enemy, the cat. Among the many plans devised, the one that found most favor was the proposal to tie a bell to the neck of the cat, that the mice, being warned by the sound of the tinkling, might run away and hide themselves in their holes at his approach. But when the mice further debated who among them should thus bell the cat,
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.